maybe my most memorable concert. I mean, it was maybe my first concert as an artist, you know, as a guest. It was with Dimitri Setskovetsky and Katia Bunatishvili, and we played the Chedrin trio. I remember it was quite complicated, and we didn't have so much rehearsals. So I had, you know, it was at the beginning of my career, and I had to be really focused. And it was a great experience for me because you learn a lot, you know, when you play with people with much more experience than you. I was 16 years old, so I was not allowed to go in the pub Montfort, you know, this pub. So yeah, exactly, the legendary pub in Verbier. And so with my friends here, who are much more older than me, we had to find a lot of tricks to be able to go to the pub. So yeah, I guess it's something funny now when I think about that. Montaigne. Music. I don't know, it's quite simple, but not a ritual, but I like to sleep in the afternoon, you know, before going on stage when I play on the night concerts, and I like to eat a banana just before going on stage. It's not a ritual, sometimes it's impossible, you know, to sleep, and sometimes it's impossible to find a banana. So I have to manage with that, but yeah, I'm quite comfortable, you know, when I can have both before concerts. I guess it's really a classic for a cellist, but I guess Mislav Rostropovich, because I started the cello when I was 3 or 4 years old, so I was really, really young. And since I began the cello, my moms and dads were all the time, you know, they put the Mislav Rostropovich albums at home, and you know, I was listening all the time, all his album. So I guess it's my first, you know, idol, because that's the musicians who, you know, put inside me like this passion. And you know, I think I wanted to become a cellist, you know, thanks to him. So yeah. I think when I went to the Tchaikovsky competition when I was 17, so you know, it was of course an historical competition. It is an historical competition, and it was crazy for me because, you know, I was also quite young, sorry to say that all the time, but that's just true. And I was not expecting, you know, to go on the final or something like that, you know, but just, you know, I passed the first round, I passed the second round, I passed the third, and I was on final, and I won the second prize. So it was a little bit crazy. And I remember at the beginning when I went to Moscow for the competition, I took like a little suitcase, you know, with like three t-shirts and three boxers, and you know, because I was expecting, you know, to come back home really, really early in the competition, and so I had to do shopping there. For the first years, I smoked. You know, I was talking to my parents, yeah, don't worry, it's just my friends around me who smoke, and you know, it was me, yeah. I think quite early also, maybe, you know, nightclubs are forbidden before 18 in France. And I think when I was maybe 16 with a friend, I went to a nightclub and I was really proud, you know, I had the impression to do something really crazy, you know, it was one of the best days of my life, I guess. Yeah, wow. Interesting questions. Quite early also, you know, I begin to smoke early. You can, yeah. I don't drink anymore, you know, so. But I begin really early. I guess when I was a baby with my sisters and brothers. I didn't eat a raclette here in Verbier. So I have to celebrate the 25 years of Verbier with a good raclette. I ate a lot of sweet chocolates, and I didn't count, to be honest. I was young. I think it was maybe 5-6 years ago. The thing is that I have still a young face, you know, like I don't grow up so much, so it's difficult, you know, to know exactly.